जय बाबा। माइंड स्टॉप्ड इज गॉड, माइंड वर्किंग इज मैन, माइंड वर्किंग फास्ट इज मैड, माइंड स्लोड डाउन इज मस्ट। मेहर बाबा, अवतार मेहर बाबा की जय। थैंक यू बाबा फॉर दिस मीटिंग एंड जय बाबा टू ऑल ऑफ यू। लेट्स स्टार्ट द synopsis of what we've done so far. We all know natural light, self, real I, God, Paramatma, mind stopped. It is knowledge, it is the everything, and it is the sound sleep in awake state. This is what we are adding now to our what you should design. Sound sleep in awake state. That means in awake state, the mind is not there, but the consciousness is there of I am God. That is natural light. Natural darkness, we have seen, it is the existence or the astitva of natural light. It is also the darkness, real darkness, or nothingness. It is also called khuda, or it is also known as the sound sleep state. And we've done it over and over again, that natural light and natural darkness move hand in hand. Now on the other side, that means both these form, in a sense, a part of reality. And now on the other side, we have the imagination, we have the illusion, we have the dewy, the duality, etc., which is unnatural darkness. We have seen that unnatural darkness is the working mind, or the false I, or egoism, you see, which is limited in everybody. The working mind is limited in everybody. It is the dream and the awake state, both the states, in the dream state as well as in awake state, we are supposed to be in natural darkness. It is ignorance, it is banda, it is slave. Then we have seen unnatural light. Unnatural light means the body, the universe, the Maya, and all the experiences are also called the shadow or the reflection of Paramatma. Then we have seen that in the awake state, now for example, now we are in the awake state, the spirit has transformed itself into mind and is experiencing the body and the universe. In the sound sleep state, the mind becomes one with the spirit, and the spirit sees the natural light, which means God or the real I or Paramatma, whatever it is. But unfortunately, in that state, we are in unconsciousness. If we are able to be one with the spirit, if the mind is completely annihilated, absolutely annihilated, one with the spirit, that means in the awake state, if there is no mind, and the mind merges with the spirit, or rather mind becomes the spirit, then that is God realization. Then we have seen that in order for the mind to become one with the spirit, it has to pass over these seven planes of consciousness. And that seven planes of consciousness, you need a lot of concentration. And by concentration, I interpreted as going within or looking within, which means external influences are less and less on us. But Baba says when you concentrate on the first plane, you get very enchanted with so many sights and sounds and perfumes of the first state, and then on to the second state, and then on, that you might tend to get hooked onto that, as a result of which you don't move further. In short, what Baba is trying to say is that howsoever much we may make an effort, you cannot reach the mind stop state except with the help of a perfect master, a living perfect master, which is equivalent to the avatar also, who's the eternal living perfect master. And then we had seen last time, very beautifully Baba said, that every time the awake state goes into the sound sleep state, it has to pass through the dream state. Every time the mind comes out of the sound sleep state and comes into the awake state, it has again to pass into the dream state. In other words, awake state, the dream state, sound sleep state, dream state, awake state. And then Baba had said later on that if the pull of the mind of the awake state is more than the pull of the sound sleep state, then you remain in the dream state more and you tend to remember your dreams. Conversely, if the pull of the sound sleep state is more, you tend to remain in the dream state less and you tend to forget your dreams when you wake up. So this is so much, so far I think we have done. If I have forgotten anything, I don't know. We'll wrap it up later on. I would now request Soumya to read from, I know we'll be repeating page 30. So am I right? Are we doing page 30? Anybody has a track? I think we are doing page 30. Yes, 30, 31, correct. So Soumya will now read it.
When mind from the awakening state, number one, enters the sleep state, number 3, he has to pass through the dream state, number 2, which is in the middle state.
I think we've done this before, but for sake of repetition, it's perfectly okay to do it. Baba has given three, one state, one as the awake, state two as the dream, and state three as the sound sleep. Go ahead, Soumya.
In this dream state, the middle of one and three, some of the one awake and some of the three sleep is experienced. And when the pulling of the awake state is more, that is, when the mind is in the awake state without rest, is entangled much in world and worldly affairs, and of sleep, that is mind to stop, rest and forget worldly affairs.
That means when the pull of the sleep is more, the mind tends to forget the worldly affairs. Go ahead.
It remains in dream mode accordingly, and so the dream is remembered. But when the pulling of the awake state is less and of sleep more, it remains less in the dream state accordingly, and so one does not remember the dream and sometimes does not even know that it has been in the dream state. Although before acquiring the sound sleep state, it must pass through the dream state.
So this is what I have already explained. It's very simple to understand the two states and why we sometimes remember the dream and sometimes do not even remember the dream or don't even feel that we have gone through the dream state. All right.
And if the pulling of the awake state, number 1, is continual, it remains in the dream state only and does not reach the state of sound sleep, but returns to the awake state without going to the sound sleep state at all.
In other words, sometimes we feel that we have not slept at all. Although we are sleeping, we have not slept at all. We do not have the feeling of having a restful sleep. That means that the pull of the awake state is so much that it is not allowing us to go into the sound sleep state, and it is keeping us only latakta, as we say, in abeyance, in the dream state. And then after the dream state, we come out awake, but we feel that we have not rested.
That if the pull of the awake state is too much more, then it will not allow us to reach the sound sleep state, as a result of which, without going into the sound sleep state. Sorry, 1 second. And in God hand, the passcode. Okay, sorry. Soumya also is gone. I don't know why. So without entering the sound sleep state, we get up, we get into the awake state, as a result of which we feel not very restful because the force of the awake state did not allow our mind to go into the sound sleep state. Is that right? So far, so good. On entering the sound sleep state and while it's remaining there, that means the mind experiences nothing. We all know that when we go into the sound sleep state, we are in the same state as Parashvar Parabrahma. We have done that before. And therefore, okay, Samya is reading. And therefore, we are in the state of nothing. But if we are in the state of nothing, the same nothing, sound sleep state, in the awake state, then that is God realization. Samya, go ahead.
On entering the sound sleep state and whilst remaining there, it experiences nothing. And whilst returning from the sound sleep state to the awakening state, it has again to pass in the dream state, and returning whilst in the dream state, if the pulling of sound sleep is more, and this generally does happen, it having just returned from sound sleep.
So that is what we
it remains in the dream state longer, and so remembers it. And if the pulling of sound sleep is less, this happens in the case of those who remain longer in the dream state and less in the sound sleep state whilst, and that of the awakening, more it remembers not long in the dream state. This all about the ordinary mind, and now about the saint's mind.
No, let's not do the saint's mind. I'll explain the ordinary mind first. Okay.
Okay.
Otherwise, everybody will go into sound sleep state. So, let me read this again. On entering the sound sleep state, and whilst remaining there, it, that means the mind, experiences nothing. We have done that. That in the sound sleep state, there is nothing. There is nothing. And whilst returning from the sound sleep state to the awakening state, it has again to pass in the dream state. I think it is very clear. Absolutely anybody can understand that going to the sound sleep state from the awake state, we go via the dream state. Similarly, coming back into the awake state, we come from the sound sleep to the dream to the awake state. It is very simple. And returning whilst in the dream state, if the pull of the sound sleep is more, and this generally does happen, it having just returned from the sound sleep, it, the mind, remains in the dream state longer, and returning whilst in the dream state, if the pull of sound sleep is more, it, that means the mind, remains in the dream state longer and so remembers. And if the pull of the sound sleep is less, this happens in the case of those who remain longer in the dream state, and less while in the sound sleep state. And if that is the pulling of the sound is more, it remains not long in the dream state. Okay. Now what Bab is trying to say, this is quite a little complex in the sense that if whilst returning from the sound sleep,
that whilst coming from the sound sleep to the awake state, if the pull of the sound sleep is less, this happens in the case of those who remain longer in the dream state. See, either you are in sound sleep or you are in dream state, or you are in the awake state. Now, Baba says that if the pull of the sound sleep is less, and this happens in the case of those who remain longer in the dream state, that means if you remain in the dream state longer, it means that the pull of the sound sleep was less. And less whilst in the sound sleep state, and if that means the pulling of the awake state is more, it remains not long in the dream state. Okay, this sounds a little confusing, but I think it's very clear cut that if at the time of waking up from the sound sleep, we pass through the dream state and then we come to the awake state. Now, if the pull, that's what Baba is trying to say, let's try to understand it in simple language. If the pull of the awake state is more, That means we remain in the sleep, in the dream state less. In which case, what happens is you do not remember your dream. Let's say, for example, if I'm very comfortably sleeping in sound sleep state and somebody is waking me up suddenly, then what happens is the pull of the awake state is much more. And although I do pass even for a few split seconds into the dream state and then come back into the awake state, I do not remember the dream because the pull of the awake state was more. Now about the saint's mind. Now this is about the ordinary person's mind. There are three states: awake, dream, sound sleep. Sound sleep, dream, awake. And Baba has given both the functionality by going from the awake state to the sound sleep and from sound sleep to the awake state. What happens where the pull is more and the pull is less. Now we go on to, now about the saint's mind. It passes upwards from the sound sleep state to the real awakening and not the downward to the false awakening. When we awaken every day, supposedly every day in the morning, we awaken in the false awake state. But in the case of spiritually aspirants, Baba calls it saints, but anybody who's on the spiritual path, when they, in the involutionary process, when they awaken in not the false awake state as we do, but they awaken in the real awakening state, right? This upward and downward, etc., is an illustration for understanding. There is no upward, there is no downward. Baba says everything is within us and it has to pass through the dream state. This dream is the middle point of the two kinds of sound sleep. Okay, now there are number 3 and number 5, which we have not seen. Let me see. Okay. Middle points of two kinds of sound sleep. That is number 3, which is the sound sleep state, and number 5, which is the divine awakening state. Now, for that, we'll have to switch on to page number 83 of the big book and 29 of Baba's handwriting. 29 of Baba's handwriting, you will see, that first you go from ordinary awake state to ordinary dream state and to ordinary sound sleep state, correct? 1, 2, 3. And it becomes like this, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1. That is for ordinary human beings. Now, so far as the saintly people are concerned, those in the involutionary journey on the spiritual path, they also go into the dream, into the sound sleep state, but they awaken in the divine awakening. That is the fifth state. Okay, so now let us see what Baba has to say here. Baba says, this dream state is the middle point of the two kinds of sound sleep. That is the third and the fifth. Third state we have seen is the ordinary sleep state, and the point 5 is the real state or the divine awakening, which is the sound sleep in awake state, and they go through the dream, which is called the divine dream. So in other words, like how we go from 1, 2, 3, they would be going from 3 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 3, till such time as they actually awaken from 3 to 4 to 5. Now let's go beyond and see. But number 5, but number 5 means sound sleep in awake state. That we have done. Number 5 is the divine awakening or the sound sleep in awake state. So this crossing point between the two, that is number 4, is the state of experiencing the divine dream, and it is called the Turiya state. Just as how we go into the ordinary dream state in point number 2, the advanced souls go through the divine dream state, which is point number 4. Summary. Now Baba is giving the summary. If the ordinary mind in the awake state detaches itself, that is turns back from, or that is forgets, disattaches itself, that is turns back from, that is forgets from the body and the world, that is, for that time, gives up enjoying and experiencing the world through the body and concentrates on the divine, it is said to have started from the ordinary sound sleep number 3 to divine sound sleep number 5, and from its going from 3 to 5. In other words, what Baba is trying to say is that in order for a normal man who is in the awake state to go from the ordinary dream to the divine dream, and from the divine dream to the real awakening, he has to withdraw himself. That means he has to withdraw his body and his mind and the worldly of. That means he has to withdraw from the pleasures of the world. He has to withdraw himself, the body and the mind and the attachment from the world and all its maya. Only then it will transform itself from going into the ordinary dream state into the divine dream state. That is, from its advancement in the concentration, it has to process through the divine dream state, that is the 7 planes, till it reaches the awakening sound sleep, that is number 5, where no dream, only sound sleep, prakash, only sound is equal to prakash. I think it means the same thing, that for an ordinary mind, which is in the ordinary awake state, when it goes into the sound sleep state, it goes through the ordinary dream state. Now, if that same mind has to go and progress further from the awake state to the divine dream state, and from the divine dream state to the prakash, which is the 5th point, which is the final awakening state or real awakening state, the only thing that is required is that it has to withdraw its consciousness from the body and the world and the maya and its attractions and its experiences, and withdraw it to a point where it reaches the Turiya Avastha and then the divine awakening. But Baba has kept on saying it over and over again, that all this is possible only, the final stage, I mean, only with the assistance of a living perfect master. All right. Anybody has any questions?
Nita has a question. Nita?
Who?
Nita.
Yes, go ahead, please. Please go ahead.
Jai Baba Cyrus, when you say a saint's mind, when you say a saint's mind, does that mean that he has started to climb the planes and has come out of the gross into the...
Baba talks about, I'll tell you. Baba uses the terminology saint later on in life to people who are on the 5th and the 6th planes of consciousness. But here Baba has used the saint, and in my understanding, it connotes somebody who has started traversing the spiritual path. That means the involutionary journey. Right? That means not ordinary mind, not the ordinary mind like ours mind, but people who have now started traversing or walking the spiritual path, the involutionary journey, starting from the 1st plane of consciousness and ending in the 7th plane of consciousness.
Okay, got that. Thank you.
Okay. Right. Anybody else?
No, Cyrus.
Cyrus, uncle, I have a question.
Pari.
Yes, my dear. Pari, bolo.
I wanted to confirm something. So, for ordinary people, we go from 1, 2, 3 and back from 3 to 1. But for a saint...
1, 2, 3, 3 to 1. Yes.
And for a saint, they will be going from 1, 2, 3, 4 and back from 4, 3, 2, 1.
He won't go through the 2. He won't go... No. He won't go through the 2. He will toggle between 3 and 4, 3, 4, 4, 3, till such time as they awaken in 5. And once you are awakened in 5, the journey ends, the traveling ends at all. You know, you are in the real awake state.
Oh, so he doesn't come back to 1 because he is not gross conscious.
Exactly.
Okay. Yes. Understood. Exactly. Thank you. Yes. Thank you.
Now you are in which state now?
Regular awake state.
All right. Okay.
I process the impossible jevu che, jo ke ekada banya che, ane te loko manzil dar manzil nau nara sale ganai che, an ek second ma banav nara sadguru ganata nathi.
See, actually, this has been written in Baba's literature. It has been written on page 34 of Baba's page, but then it has been cancelled out. So here what Baba is trying to say is that it's a very rare case that people can do it on their own. It is very rare that somebody can do it on their own. And they are not Sadgurus. Banavara Sadguru, Ganatina Sadguru, I don't know what exactly Baba is trying to convey, because he has cancelled it out. And he has said that maybe one may reach that goal on its own, something like that. And then these Salikas make manzil within manzil, that is plane within plane, in their own experience. That is, they progress plane to plane until they reach realization. This is, of course, these are all the words given by the editors. They are not Baba's words. Okay? They are not Baba's words. We would just read them because the editors added over here. A literal translation of the Gujarati year would. This is on page number 34 of Baba, which has been written and crossed out. It is written in Gujarati. So the literal translation I am reading, it says Salik. Now, as I told earlier, Baba has later on differentiated between Salik and Sadgurus. Saliks are those who, after God realization, get back the consciousness of the duality and all the seven planes of consciousness, including the gross plane, etc. But they have no duties to perform. And Sadgurus have the additional duties to perform. But here Baba is using the word Saliks. It says, Saliks. Who are makers of manzil within manzil. Conceivably, this could be interpreted to mean that these saliks make manzil within manzil, which means plane within plane, in their own experiences. That is, that they progress from plane to plane until they reach realization. More probably, however, these saliks produce this experience of progress from plane to plane within others. The translation above is based on this second reading. Okay, now again I'll read the second reading. Literally, the Gujarati translation thus, amongst the makers in a second, Sadgurus. Though again, Baba does not specify what the Sadgurus are makers of. One can infer from other discourses of Baba's and from his discussion of the same subject on page 37, which we'll do later on, of this text, that he is referring to the establishment of the God realization in others. Well, to be very honest, I'm not very clear about this. Maybe I'll give a little thought to it in our next reading. I wasn't prepared, frankly, today for this particular episode. What has happened, what Baba is trying to say is, no, I would reserve my interpretation for a second session, for a next session. I'll just try to delve a little deeper into this and tell you, because I don't want to put on record anything that I'm not personally able to understand. We'll work on this a little later. All right. Now, 1 minute. Okay, so now, today what we did was that there are three states of consciousness, the sound sleep, the dream, and the awake. And for an ordinary human being, we go from one, which is the awake state, to two, which is the dream state, to three, which is the sound sleep state, and then we come back. Then we also discussed about the pull, if the pull of the sound sleep is more, if the pull of the awake state is more, then where do you go between the dream and whether you remember the dream or you do not remember dream. Remember the dream. We also seen that if the pull of the awake state is too much in the initial stage before going into the sound sleep state, then you will not be able to reach the the sound sleep state. You will continue to remain in the dream state and come back into the awake state. And my interpretation, my addition to that was, in that case, you do not feel refreshed when you wake up from the sleep because you have never entered the drowned sleep state, the sound sleep state. And then we have seen today again that this is for the ordinary human minds, for those who are on the spiritual path, on the involutionary journey. For them, it's a different set of awakening and sound sleep. They say that when they wake up from sound sleep state, they go into the Turiya Avastha or the divine dream state, which is state 4 as given in the chart. And they toggle between those two states till such time as they awaken into the real awakening state, which is point number 5 in the chart, in which case they experience the sound sleep in awake state, which is the same thing as realization. They have realized. So I think we close the session now. Okay.
Yes, Jai Baba.
Okay, Sarasangal. Thank you so much. Jai Baba.
Thank you, Baba.